Got a good video for you today. I've come to the Ping Factory, the European fitting center. I want some new irons. Join me on my journey. Which ones will I choose? It's gonna be good. I'm excited. Come down to the fitting bays. This is some setup. It's changed a fair amount since I was here as a girl. Now, Nick Bolton, he's Mr. Ping, really. He's been here longer than I have. 34 years at Gainsborough. Amazing. Changed a lot, hasn't it?
It's changed a hell of a lot since I've been here, yeah. I think I started in the shop as an assistant pro and then went across the factory and been sort of fitting since about 96. So, you know, when we started, it was three to Sandine, everybody, and one shaft. So there's lots of things.
A lot of change.
Yeah, hybrids and...
There won't be any three irons today. I can't hit them. But we're going to try and my clubs, and then I'm going to try and move on to what I fancy from Ping. So I'm looking at i525s. Nick's looked at all my past history of the many times I've visited Gainsborough, and he's going to help me try and find the right irons today. Everybody has the same expert fitting here at Ping, but before I even hit a golf shot, Nick is going to take some measurements.
Yep, okay, so what's your height, Sophie?
In centimetres or feet, I'm 5'4".
Feet and inches, yeah.
5'4".
Well, we can do centimetres.
Not very tall, 164 centimetres.
Okay, and then wrist to floor measurement, we're going to just stand with your arms at your side, nice and relaxed, arms by your side, and then we're just going to take a measurement of your wrist, and it's from the first crease, and that's 31.5. Thank you. So that's given us a starting point where we're going to look at the colour code chart and we're going to equate your height and arm length together, and that puts us onto that colour code.
The famous colour code chart at Ping. So what am I equating to here, Nick?
So you're equating to, if we look at your height, which is across here, and then we come down, we come to 31.5, which is your wrist to floor measurement. That's bang in the middle of the shaded area, which is your length idea. So it's red colour code, and that's our starting point with the fitting.
That is 1 degree flat, and you can see at the bottom the reasons why you need to get the right lie angle. But that's obviously the baseline. We need to know what I deliver the club at, so there could be some room for manoeuvring around here. But that's our start base at the red dot, so we'll go from there now. Now I've brought my irons, so I've got my 7-iron here. I'm going to get some baseline numbers, but check this out. Pyramids and Titleist Pro V1Xs. How good's that? It's not just me that's going to get these golf balls. You will too if you come for a fitting at Gainsborough. Got the track man behind me. I'm just going to loosen up and hit some shots and tell Nick really what I like to see my ball flight do. Because remember, these fittings are all about you. Now, quick tip, it can be quite nervous being in here, people watching in this scenario. So if you do get the chance, maybe go to the driving range the day before, or at least have had a go on a track man. You can get some numbers, you can bring them to your fitter and say, this is what I normally do. Because on the day, if you're nervous and you're not hitting it too well, you might not get the fitting that you want. So bring some history with you. So you can say, this is actually how far I normally hit my 7-iron and the shape that you hit it. I think I'm about done, Nick. Loosened up, I've hit the ball all right there. So I'm gonna look at my numbers and see what I want. I think I know what I want. I know my game well enough. I wanna get the flight down a touch so I can hit it a few yards further. Flight is just not strong enough at the moment. Game's changed a lot over the last year and a half with these clubs, and I think I need some help, but let's see what Nick thinks. So Nick, what's the first one we're gonna try?
So the first one's a red lie angle, which is from the colour code chart, and a shaft that's very similar to what you've been using currently. And the head is the i525.
So forged head, similar to that P770 in look. So it looks bladey, but it's going to give me a bit more punch?
Hopefully.
Okay.
Hopefully we'll see.
Now I choose to look at these numbers. You can put yourself in the capable hands of Nick I am doing, because he's done all right so far. I'm noticing some more yardage for me.
Yeah, it's certainly gone a little bit further, 5 yards on the carry there. Your ball speed has jumped a little bit. You know, your ball speed's jumped up by about 3 miles an hour. Launch angle's down a little bit. And then also spin rate's down about 400. So launching a bit lower, spinning it a touch lower. You've carried it further, but then your total distance as well is actually up 7 yards.
Yeah, it doesn't matter to me, I would say, about total distance. It's all about carry with my irons. And that spin rate, it's in the high 5,000s. Actually got one at 6,000. So it's not significantly low that it's starting to scare me. But that's good. That's an easy 7 iron, actually. I gained yardage without even trying.
Yeah, and you're still going to get the ball stopping because that landing angle, as I said earlier, is coming in nice and steep. So you're still going to get the ball stopping on the green nicely, even though you've just dropped a little bit of spin rate.
Well, we've gained in the first club that we've tried. Is there anything you would do now?
Just try some different shafts.
Now, the reason I'm here is because in my review for the Ping i525s, I liked them. Check out the link below. The smile remained for the whole video. I wanted to try them all out. I wanted to get them in my bag for this year. So that's why I'm only really trying the i525s, because I do think it's going to be a waste of time for me trying all the rest of them. I've already done that with Golfalot. I'm here to get that perfect iron for me. Nick switched me out of the graphite into a steel shaft. It's a 95 gram regular flex though. What I'm looking for is to lower that launch. With a graphite, sometimes you do get the pop. So if you need high launch, try graphites. But for me at the moment, I want to get that launch down. So I'm hoping that the steel shaft will do that. Now, I used to use steel when I played on tour, switched to graphite because I needed some more help. I think I'm now at the stage where I've almost got too much help and they're going high. I need it to flatten out that ball flight, give myself a few more yards with these irons. I've just sent Nick over to have a look at maybe a different version of graphite, because the steel is doing its job. I don't feel it's outperforming the graphite. Maybe when I get to a 4 iron, that graphite shaft's going to help me a bit more than in a 7 iron. So I'm just going from what I'm feeling right now, because that's Nick needs that. He's got the numbers, he can see the ball flight, but he needs to know what the player is feeling. So we're going with my thoughts now to try and find a way of getting me into the right club. Gone back to the graphite, but we've gone a stiff version of the graphite shaft. Didn't get that one. Now it's okay to say, Nick, just get rid of that one. You are going to hit some bad shots and we're going to look at averages a lot of the time, so it's okay to go, no, can we take that one out of the equation? Obviously if it keeps happening, then we can start blaming the equipment, can't we? And that's another thing to know, if you've hit 3, 4, 5 shots with a club and you're not there, you don't like the look of it, it doesn't sound right off the face, tell your fitter straight away, because they'll just change you out of it and go, okay, great, let's not hit something that's not right for us. We've got hundreds of choices here, so don't waste your time and your energy hitting something which isn't right for you. So put your hand up and say, no, can we change it again? And they'll be thankful for it, and you will too, because it can get quite tiring hitting lots and lots of golf balls. Ooh, there was something in that one. Nick, talk to me.
So you look at that last shot, your ball speed was up over the 100, 102, which is like at least 5 mile an hour quicker than earlier on the i525s. 8 miles an hour on your first, your own clubs.
So launch was down, but it felt, you know what, it felt quick, but I still had enough flight to it. So it's launch angle 47, that's good. Spin is a touch lower than what I'd like, but that's just the odd one. You get that when you hit something really well. Sometimes your ball speed does come down. Your ball speed does go up and your spin comes down because of that notion there. You've got a little bit more out of the golf shot. That's a positive. That's those last 3 shots that I've hit with this shaft. I've felt something.
Yeah, your launch angle again was a little bit lower, as you can see, 22 compared to 23. landing angle still similar at 47, distance 1 through at 36, carry. So it's 6 yards further. Yeah.
And also I'm seeing something here, 83 feet that 7-iron went. And if you look at compared to what I've been hitting with the other ones, it's not like the ball flight's dropped significantly, is it? It's that they've all been around 80 feet in the air flight. So the height is going to stop the ball on the green, even though the spin has slightly dropped.
Exactly.
Oh, I'm excited. I have another go. Yeah, I'm happy with this. Would you do anything else? Are we nearly there?
Yeah, I just want to try another graphite shaft that we do in graphite, and that's the UST recoil.
Seems like we've committed to the graphite shaft. We're just going to try another one, which you never know. But the good news is I'm getting close to the iron that I want. Don't like that, but I think that's a good thing because there was a big difference between that graphite shaft, the stiff one, and this new one. And just didn't feel like I can control it. I had a quick look at the spin numbers, and when we're dropping to 4,000s, that's too low for me. I need to keep it in the 5,000s, and I've just looked at Nick's face. He doesn't look happy with it either. We switched back to my favourite, the stiff shaft, the graphite alter shaft. And it's more of a confirmation. I can feel in myself now that this is for me. As soon as Nick's passed it over, I've got that, oh yes, I want these to be my irons. That's a good place to be. We're just gonna check it really, and then we'll go over anything else that needs to be done when getting custom fit irons. Well, I think I've found my iron of choice. The i525 was always going to be the model, but Nick has just helped me find the correct one with the shaft and the lie angle. So let's have a look at these numbers, because I wanted to gain a couple of yards and I have done. Looking at the before and after, everything we were talking about maybe lowering the launch, taking some spin off, we've done that with the new irons, haven't we? And the graphite shaft. So what ones are you thinking is significant? I mean, obviously I'm looking at it thinking I've gained nearly a club in distance, bonus.
Yeah, absolutely. So you from your own, your ball speed has jumped up by 4 miles an hour.
Yeah.
So that's a great thing. Your launch is down a little bit. Your launch is 2 degrees lower. Your spin is down a little bit, down by 400. Because that launch angle is high anyway, it's not going to affect you too much into the greens because it's still going to stop because you do launch it quite high. And then that distance, you've gained 8 yards on your carry, 1-2-4 with your own to 1-32.
Yeah, and I'm looking a little bit further on, like landing angle, that's only come down less than 2 degrees. Height, I've only lost 2 feet. That's on average. So actually, the ball's going to stop on the green still, even though I've lost a bit of spin, but I've gained that yardage. Now, you've just mentioned something about power lofts. What's that?
Power spec. So if you wanted to get the launch down even further, what we can do is use what we call power spec, which is just taking a little bit of loft off the clubs, and that'll just launch it even lower. Obviously, the significance of that is then you can reduce your spin even more. So not always a good thing.
Yeah, that's a good thing to know, isn't there? That there's other lofts available. We used to call them tall lofts, they're now called power lofts. I'm going to say no, just for the reason is that I've already lost 400 in spin. Yeah, I'm going to lose more, which I'm going to gain more distance, but that's going to be quite a lot for me to get used to over a club in distance, but it's the way the ball's going to react when it hits the green. That's a lot for me to get used to. So I'd like to thank you for offering it, but I can see by your face that even you're going, you know, as a good player, that's going to take some time. And we're mid-season now, and I don't mind a bit of a change, but that seems quite a lot for me. So I'm going to stick to standard. Happy?
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, if Nick's happy, I'm happy. What a day it's been here at the Ping Factory. It's some setup, and this is some iron that I'm going to be playing from now on. It's the Ping i525 forged. I've got a graphite shaft, a stiff alter graphite shaft, red dot, It's what I've had my entire life. I've been 5'4" since I was 13 years old. But that ball flight there was something which made me stand up and notice. I came looking for a few extra yards, but not a bullet ball flight that's not going to stop on the green. I got that with these. They're giving me a lot of confidence. I'm going to stick with my Golf Pride Tour Velvet Grip. I've had that for years. It's what I feel comfortable with. And the great thing about Nick is he's researched my game of all my past stuff that I've used at Ping. He's been open to what I want, as well as putting all his feedback in and all the information that he's gathered. I felt we've really worked well as a team today. And that's what's going to happen when you come to Ping as well. They're going to speak to you. They're going to ask you about your game. And you're going to walk away with the right iron for you. What a day. I've loved it. Thanks for having me, Ping. What a place this is. Thank you very much for Nick, for having me, all the Ping family. It's good to come back. It's been a while. The face says it all. I've got my new irons for this year. Can't wait to get those in the bag. But you too can also get fitted for Ping clubs. Contact your local pro. You get to come down to Gainsborough, the European Fitting Centre, and find the right clubs for you, from woods to putters. Now, I got the irons I wanted, the Ping i525s. I'm sure you'll get what you need also. So once again, from Golfalot, thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe to our channel. Check out all our new content with my new irons in. And we will see you again soon. Thank you, Ping, for having me. I've had a great time.